Welcome back to EarthBound. First thing I need to do is actually grab a little bit of money. Since we need to do things. Essentially, we want to go to the next place. Scaraba? I'm not sure how it's supposed to be pronounced. But I don't think the boat guy will take us there yet. Not quite. Magic hate lady. Stop using leftover materials. I got food poisoning last time. I'm pretty sure if there's a little pile of vomit with Ness's name all over it. I actually do want to check to see if that guy would take us to Scaraba right now. Because I know what we're supposed to do, obviously. I've been in the game 5 billion times. But there is... no. How did I avoid this last time? Like, seriously. Also, the lower right, I don't know what that's supposed to be. The black part that has, like, eyes in it? Is that supposed to be evil-looking, as evil as I think it's supposed to be? It's looking on in judgment. Hello! No! I've killed lots of monsters at this point. Hello! Oh, he actually will take us right away. Shiver in fear for your future. Wow, that's actually kind of evil. That is not supposed to what we're supposed to do, though. I didn't know that you could just go directly there and skip this part of what we're supposed to be doing. However, you really, really, really should visit the museum first. Trust me. Otherwise, you're going to be missing out on sanctuaries. Yeah. Sure. Why not? I have to do this. Tutankhamun's casket. Those are some really big pencils, guys. Oh boy, Pokey. Lunch? Wow. I'm surprised Pokey didn't take that. Ram raisin? Really? Has it always been ram raisin? And I've never noticed that. Well, I don't know how that's supposed to be funny, but the raisin. Yeah. He really just took it. In Omar's inventory previously, which I did have, was a tiny ruby. Which, you know, I didn't know saying no, he would take it anyway, the damn thief! You know, at this point of the game, every time I do this, because this is right after, you know, Mr. Samurai Boy joins the party, one, he goes, oh, my life is for you, or whatever his exact words were. And then it's, oh, you know, give up one of your possessions so we can go into this room that's being remodeled. I mean, okay, he is the crown prince, so maybe a tiny ruby isn't that big of a deal to him. And, you know, through his mental training, maybe he doesn't have a big attachment to, you know, material possessions. But we just met the guy, and we're like, yeah, give him your stuff. Yeah. It's always felt a little bit strange, and those are enemies. There is an interesting glitch with this game, with this room. Later on in the game, you get the opportunity to walk around and talk to people after the game is done. And all the enemies are gone, except for these guys. You can actually come here and get a game over after the game's done. I don't remember what else happens. It's maybe just one of those things. I think some other stuff happens because the game's like, what am I doing? Because you're not supposed to get a game over. Maybe it just game overs you and that's it. I don't actually remember the full details of that little bug. The Shattered Man attacks. Not to mention, this would be a decent chance to, get a little bit of EXP for Omar. This shouldn't be that difficult. It really shouldn't, especially with Paula with us again. And that's it. I just have to do that one more time, and yeah. 11,000 experience for a very easy fight. Mummy wrap. Of course, Omar's going to level. Level 20. Lots of HP, that's good. Yeah, not only does Omar get PSI freeze, not as high as Paula, let's be fair, but he also gets PSI magnet, and I do believe he gets Omega as well. So, yeah, that's Omar's big advantage. Not only that, but he gets magnet, and he has healing powers. His only disadvantage right now is he's extremely fragile. That's the problem. Although I think Omar gets PSI Thunder Omega and Paula does not. But then again, Omar has healing powers. I mean, this is what you were thinking when you got Paula for the first time. It's like, oh, I really wish she had healing power. Once you get Magnet, I really wish she had healing powers. And then you get Omar and it's like, oh, thank you, game! that letter. And, of course, Omar's going to get a ton of levels. Not anything too fantastic, but it does help. Yeah. Oh! He also took a... You're a dishonest man, aren't you? Well, you can tell that just by the mustache. Protected by the gods of Scaraba. Even farther beyond the lost underworld. Deep darkness is shrouded, it is without light. Only one with a hawk eye can pierce the dark. That last little bit is very important, by the way. Yeah. So off to Scaraba. I mean, without that information, I don't think you can get into the Sphinx. Huh. Yeah, thank you, sir. Oh, no, it's actually the whole thing. I thought it was just going to give the, you know, this being a huge hint to what you're doing next in the game. You know, the Hawkeye, the Sphinx, everything, and especially that part. That's the most important bit. I mean, you can ignore the rest of it and just keep progressing and, you know, you'll figure out everything else on your own. But that one little bit, you need that. You definitely need that. Really? Where's the receptionist? You can actually leave? Oh, boy. Where is this lady? No? I'm not Mr. Fork. Hi? Well, I guess curiosity. So back to Foreside. Because we did see that, one sanctuary that I couldn't get to. Yeah. And not too excited about going there, actually. Thankfully, the PSI teleport boots you right off in front of the museum, which helps quite a bit. it never feels like you can really get... Oh, and also, sneak in... Oh. Yeah, you can't sneak into the museum. An expert, huh? And unlike Moonside, this place has a legitimate full-on skeleton. You can't see the whole thing, but here comes a photographer. Bitch is taking instantaneously. Blah 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 blah. Does anybody like him? Seriously, did anybody? Oh. Maybe it should. Well, I am kind of chubby, but you don't have to call me huge. Remember your words, sir. Just remember your words. Hello, Mr. Spoon. Now, if you remember me watching her performance, there was a man that looked, quite a bit like this man, the creeper. Yeah, not the exploding kind. Minecraft reference. Really? RPG? Really? Yeah, this guy is the creepy guy. The one who got himself, escorted off the stage. So now I need to go get the autograph from, Venus. Although, she knows that I was good friends with the Runaway Five, so, you know, possibly I would be able to. Although, I have to pay for another ticket. Yay, hello, yes please, thank you. Notice this $100 that I pulled out of the bank is disappearing quite quickly. It's always starting very shortly. What does Mummy Rap do? I don't even remember. Oh. Yeah, probably not very much damage, and it probably doesn't work half the time. Please no show. I actually have to sit through that show again. Nah, I suppose at the very least, he knows that I was friends with the Runaway Five, he likes them, he's like, yeah, sure, go in and talk to Miss Venus. I know you're on the up and up, and you're, you know, a good group of kids. Banana peel? Sure, why not? And a kiss for your trouble, those rosy red cheeks for a good reason, huh, Ness? No show? Really? Thank goodness. That's weird. Really? Okay, stop complaining, RPG, before you get stuck watching the stupid thing. Runaway 5 show, getting stuck during it, that's one thing. But, you know, then again, I did pay for a ticket and I didn't want... Well, I'm fine with that. I got what I wanted, that's all that matters. Next thing I need to do... Let's go visit Mom, actually. Why not? Oh, RPG, you suck at this. There we go. And yes, I can stay at home, get a nice full pasta meal, because, well... And the thing is, most of the default things in your list, there's not really anything in the game. But then again, you know, it's your favorite food that your mom cooks. Like, you could put in cookies, for example. But a cookie wouldn't be... It's like, oh, this is good, but this isn't Mom's cookie. That's, you know, what I wanted. You know, that's what makes him feel the best. And, yeah, the doggy. remember when 4 experience was a lot? Or at least, you know, a substantial amount? Hey, Mom. Guess who's home? I have friends. Look at me. So, Ness, who's this young lady that you've been hanging out with? And, yeah, just one bed. I don't know, one of those things that has always bothered me just a little bit. Hey, Tracy. Thank you. Because I want a cookie. How do you feel giving me a cookie, me turning around immediately and giving it back to you? Oh, and also, if you so chose, you could, I don't need the hieroglyphic copy. I know what the hint is. You can go back to Saturn Valley and pick up some more peanut cheese bars. Yeah, that should be good. I think the brain stone that Omar's holding reduces brain shock chances. Yeah, that essentially makes whoever's holding it completely immune to can't concentrate, which is really handy. I'm not going to give it to anyone. Omar can keep that. I mean, magnets? Healing abilities. That should be pretty much self-explanatory why I'm not giving that to somebody else. Yeah, back to Foreside. Course. You know, I try to be fancy. I try to get this done without a dick coil snake. Try to get this done without wasting too much time, and then I get myself all whatever. Really? I also believe that, once you start teleporting, all the sprites stop moving. That's why the truck was moving. Hey! Place all that PP that I used trying to teleport. Thank you. Anyway, back into the museum. Again. And I need to pay the admission fee. Again. Although, you know, almost every single time I try to sneak by this lady. Almost every time. Now remember that we have to pay a fee to get in here. Just remember that. Just do that for me. Hello. Yes, I know. I have one. You know, if you stop talking, I could give it to you. But no, you keep blabbing. You know, getting a signature of any celebrity or whatever that you like a lot, and it's like, oh, I got a signature of this person, yay! On a banana peel, it's like, oh yeah, it'll rot in a week and I won't be able to read it anymore. A huge monster rat? Well, he just told you the boss of this area. What did the rats do in, Onet? The place onto the first sanctuary, and yes, that we are in the sewers of Foreside. Yeah. One of the most disgusting parts of this game, by far. That's fine, I'm not worried about... definitely not now. What did the rats do early in the game? What did they do, do you remember? Yeah, the boss does that too. If you don't remember, well, you could either go watch it or just wait. Brainshock Alpha. Brainshock isn't something that I really ever use. It's just not something I normally use. Yeah, it makes one enemy feel strange. Woo. I guess it could be handy. Broken iron, that's what, slime generator for you, Jeff? Didn't I already make one of those? And, yeah, upgraded those. Unfortunately, in this area, there is no choice but to wallow through that. At least it's not, you know... Parts of the game, you know, I might have said earlier, I know I've said earlier, that, you know, maybe the game isn't as pretty as it could have been. but, you know, everything works. You can tell what everything is. I know that's a trash can. I know that's, you know, a sewer. That's concrete walls. I know what all this stuff is. I am glad at this part of the game that that water isn't better animated and whatever. It's just, And a croissant. As disgusting as it is, eating something out of a trash can, how disgusting is it eating something out of a trash can that's in a sewer? Yeah. It's, pretty disgusting. I think I want to puke a little bit. Oh, I didn't even, discuss Omar's mirror ability. And Omar's dead. Get used to this a lot. No, really. Get used to Omar being dead a lot. I'll worry about... Yeah, they're pretty much going after Omar. Actually, what I should have done is gone and picked up some of the... super plush bears over in Summers. That's what I should have done. Not like Omar's going to do a whole lot of... Why am I using that? I should be using... Well, I don't have Magnet Omega yet. It's going to take a long time for Omar to catch up. It really is. I mean, during this dungeon, he is essentially useless. He really is. I mean, there's nothing he can really do. Once he gets Magnet Omega, it'll be better, you know? But at this point, he's just kind of an experience sink. Especially when he gets levels like that. You need more offense and defense, buddy. Yeah. I'm up to my neck in sewerage. Ah, save the world, they said. Visit interesting locales, they said. And here I am wallowing in a sewer. It's disgusting. This is also what really tries my patience, because you walk so much slower through that. Just getting through here is painful. It seems like everything is just about... No. He will get Omega. I don't know when, but he will get it. Level 25. Hell, even Paul is level 37. S is all the way up to 43, and yeah, Omar is so far behind. This is, again, one of the very, very dangerous parts of the game. Mostly because of the boss, I'm not going to lie. Yeah, Omar leveled again. I've been showing level ups for this entire thing. I think we're good now. Broken Spade, 250 bucks eventually, I guess. There is an opportunity in this dungeon to level up Omar, and I really think I'm going to take it. This time around. Usually I don't. Usually I regret it. Oh no. Ooh, I haven't discussed the mirror ability yet. It's really handy. Depending on what you'd use it on. I know that's very vague, but trust me, it becomes pretty incredible depending on how you use it. I need another enemy though. Yeah, stinky ghost. Not just smelly, he's stinky. Mirror. I want to mirror the stinky ghost. This gives Omar the ability, gonna turn into the stinky ghost, to sometimes turn into your opponent. As much as I would like to spoil how handy this is, especially during certain parts of the game. Oh my goodness. Doesn't seem to work very often, though. I don't know if he just can't turn into some enemies, or if it's luck-based, or how the mirror ability works. I have no idea. But there are some enemies, especially ones that can heal, to use it, because some healing abilities that enemies have don't use PP. And they spam it. He takes on their exact behavior. Like, however, whatever they do, he... And there we go. That helps a little bit. Do I have to go down this ladder? Some of these ladders you have to go down, because there's probably going... Yep. There's also... that's spoilers and stuff. But Omar finally has... PSI Magnet Omega. Finally. Not to mention, Omar also has the... the healing ability, so he can fix people's... status ailments. So that takes a lot of the pressure off of Ness, which, to be honest, is really... that was useful. Really, really handy. But anyway, need to get rid of you. So next time, a little bit more of this horrible place with the, sewer water. Yeah, exploring the world and whatnot. Disgusting. And of course, video games mean what they are. There has to be a sewer level. No, there doesn't. There never has to be a sewer level. Like this in the ice world. Can we skip both of those, like, forever? Especially the sewer one. Especially, like, this. Like, what is this? What is that supposed to be? I mean, I can take a good guess what that's supposed to be. But, I don't know. And I like how if you walk straight into it, Ness is like nose level. That's absolutely fantastic. But anyway, next time, more creeping around, frolicking in a sewer. Yuck. Do I sound disgusted enough to you? I am, trust me.